there are all sorts of vaccines for lots of different diseases. But conventional vaccines all share some common ingredients. So, other than water, what are they made of? I asked Professor Adam Finn to explain. He was involved in the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine work, and he knows a lot about vaccines.
There's nearly always a little bit of, or maybe even all of, a microbe that would normally cause an infection and make you sick. But this time it's just going to make the immune response without making you sick.
The part that is most commonly used is the protein on the outside of a microbe, which is called an antigen. So what else is there?
So there'll be some kind of a preservative in there that basically stops the vaccine from containing something you really don't want to get. And the other thing that might be in there is something to just tweak your immune system into action. So it just kind of triggers things off and makes you get that protective response.
Those last things he mentioned are called adjuvants. Not all vaccines have or need adjuvants, but when they are sometimes present, they can help a vaccine achieve the best efficacy possible.
In many cases, without an adjuvant, the vaccine simply just doesn't work. It doesn't give you protection. So the body just ignores it, doesn't see it as a threat, and nothing happens. The other point is that you can actually use less of the antigen that you need to put in there by putting in the adjuvant. And if there's a shortage, it means that you can spread it over a much larger number of people and get more people immunized for the same amount of vaccine.
Those are the main elements of a vaccine: antigens, preservatives, and adjuvants. But then you've also got your stabilizers to keep the antigen from changing. And there's also something called residuals, which are basically just the things left over from the manufacturing process. But these are only present in vanishingly small traces. That's what's inside a vaccine. But what happens when you put all these things inside your body? How does it react?
Cells in your body that are trained really to look for foreign material in places where it shouldn't be, they're scouting around looking for that foreign material, and they scoop it up and then they carry it off to areas called lymph nodes. And that's where the immune response starts to happen. And your body responds to that and it builds up cells and antibodies that will neutralize that foreign material. And that will protect you if you then subsequently get exposed to that infection, whether it's a virus or a bacterium. And your whole body will be prepared to react to that when it arrives in a way that it wouldn't have been if you hadn't had the vaccine.
So what about the COVID jabs? Do they work like conventional vaccines? There are a few different ones around, and they work in different ways. So we're just going to focus on the COVID vaccines that have already got approval in the UK. That's the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, which involves DNA. Then there's the Moderna vaccine and the Pfizer and BioNTech vaccine, which both involve mRNA. But I'll let Adam explain how that works.
So these vaccines are also different in the sense that you're not giving little bits of the microbe or even the whole microbe. What we're doing instead is we're giving the genetic code for one part of the virus and then letting our own cells make the bits of virus that we then respond to by giving them the code to do that. So the ones we're using right now, those ones don't have adjuvants, they don't have preservatives in, and they do need to get used pretty quickly after you take them out the fridge for that reason.
These three COVID jabs just don't need a lot of the ingredients that we've mentioned, because like Adam says, these vaccines are not delivering a COVID microbe into the body. Instead, they're helping our own cells make something that looks the same as a COVID viral spike protein, so that our immune system can respond to it. The only ingredients they do share with other more common vaccines are salt, water, and sugar. So, does this mean they're safer?
Old-fashioned vaccines are things that we've used for a very long time and we know a lot about them, whereas these new ones, they're new. They're pretty straightforward. They seem to work much better than any of us expected them to. And we've gone in the last couple of months from a few tens of thousands of people and not seen any problem to many millions of people now in this country and in some of the other countries around the world. And again, no problems so far.
They are no less safe than conventional vaccines, but they are much more straightforward in the sense that they require fewer ingredients to work effectively, which is a credit to the scientific work that made them possible. But they're also new, and like all new things in science, it takes time to accumulate data to better understand how well they work.